Hello everyone, now we are going to discuss something about external commercial borrowing. So any money that has been borrowed from the foreign sources for financing the commercial activities in India are called external commercial borrowing. The Government of India permits ECB as a source of finance for Indian corporates for expansion of existing capacity as well as for fresh investment. So when an Indian corporate or an Indian bank raises an amount from the foreign sources for their commercial activity, either for expansion of existing capacity or for fresh investment, is called external commercial borrowing. These ECB policy of the government seeks to emphasize priority of investing in the infrastructure and the core sectors such as power, telecom, railways, roads, urban infrastructure, etc. There is also an emphasis on the need of capital for small and medium scale enterprises. So for the core sectors and infrastructure as well as for small and medium scale enterprises, banks as well as corporates can raise the amount from the foreign sources under the ECB. So we have also heard the term FDI. So how is foreign direct investment different from external commercial borrowing? FDI are usually in the equity market, like in the equity capital, FDI is there, and anything apart from equity capital can be termed under the ECB market. So the ECB means any kind of funding other than equity. If the foreign money is used to finance the equity capital, it would be termed as FDI. The ECB should satisfy the ECB regulation stipulated by the government or its agency such as RBI. So RBI sets the regulation for ECB as well as the limit for banks and corporates to borrow how much amount annually from the external commercial borrowings. All these limits and regulations are being set by agencies such as RBI or the government itself. The bonds, credit notes, asset-backed securities, mortgage-backed securities, or anything of that nature are included in ECB. Any investment made towards core capital of an organization such as equity shares, convertible preference shares, or convertible debentures. So here we need to note that any convertible debentures or convertible preference shares can be converted from debt to equity capital. So that is why what I have already told, that anything apart from equity capital can be termed under ECB. So the investment in the equity shares or the convertible debenture or preference share comes under the FDI policy. So henceforth, the investment under these equity shares and preference shares and convertible debenture will be under the FDI, not under the ECB. So what are the routes to access the external commercial borrowing? So external commercial borrowing can be accessed via two routes, automatic routes as well as approval route. General idea is that the external commercial borrowing for investment in industrial sector, infrastructure sector are allowed under the automatic route. So all those bank who have housing also as their housing sector also under their ambit can raise money through ECB under automatic route. So they don't need approval for that from the RBI or the Government of India. For specific sectors such as export and import, the borrower has to take explicit permission of the government before taking such loans. So it is only for sectors such as export and import, there is a requirement of approval. Elsewise, for other sectors such as industrial and infrastructure sector, it comes under the automatic route. So what are the benefits to the borrower? Why would any bank or corporate want to raise money from the international market? Why not from the domestic funds? So the cost of funds borrowed from the external sources at times is cheaper than the domestic funds. So here it is that at times it is cheaper than the domestic funds. So the people prefer to diversify their investor base, and they want to access money from outside when it is cheaper. The borrower can diversify their investor base and it opens the international market for the borrowers. External commercial borrowings from the internationally recognized sources such as banks, export credit agencies, suppliers of equipments, foreign collaborator, foreign equity holder and international market, etc. So these are the sources from where any bank or corporates can engage itself with and can have money raised, like banks, like any banks of any other country, export credit agencies, suppliers of equipment, foreign collaborators, foreign equity holders, international capital market, etc. What are the impacts and implications on economy? So the government of India has controlled policy on ECB, like there is certain limits beyond which a bank or the corporate cannot go beyond and cannot take money annually, cannot borrow money annually. Like for the banks, it is up to 750 million annually under the automatic route. So the government of India has a controlled policy on ECB via its policies, and would like the companies use the ECB to primarily fund the infrastructure and the small and medium enterprise sector of the economy. Like what I have told in the first slide, only for those projects itself the funding should be done under the ECB. The benefit for the economy is that the low cost international funds can improve inflow of more money in the sector. So low cost funding can help in improve the inflow of more money into the sector, and it can be only it is encouraged and it is made only into infrastructure sectors or for the small and medium enterprises sector as well as the core sectors. Over the years, Indian companies have increasingly dependent on ECB. Indian companies want to get loans through ECB at lower cost and lower their cost of borrowing. The external commercial borrowing increase the external debt of the market. Yes, obviously, if you borrow more from the international or the external market, so your the country's external debt also increases. That is why it has to be matched with the foreign exchange reserves in the country so as to maintain solvency. So in case there is a default, so for maintaining solvency, the foreign exchange reserves should be maintained in the country, and it has to be matched with the borrowings from with the external borrowings that the Indian corporates or banks do. Also, increase in external commercial borrowing is accompanied with increase in currency risk, as there will be depreciation in rupees, which will lead to increased burden on the borrower as the value of the rupee depreciates. Thus, the increased dependence on ECB is less favorable for borrowing countries' view. So, if the value of the currency depreciates, obviously, you have the borrower has to give a lot of money, more than earlier it was designated. Like if he has taken $1 lakh amount from the external sector or the external market, if the value at that time was let's say suppose 60 rupees, so he has to give back 60 into 1 lakh rupees. In terms of rupees, it cost him 60 into 1 lakh rupees. What if the value of the currency depreciates? Now if it becomes 70 rupees, so now the value is 70 into 1 lakh, so he has to, it will be burdensome on his pocket because he has to give $1 lakh back with the interest also. But as the value of the money depreciates, he has to put in more money. Like it will cost him more in terms of his or her domestic currency. It will cost him or her more, because as the value of the currency depreciates, it will be burdensome on him or her pocket. And if ECBs are not controlled, there can be huge debt causing problems for the economy. What are the policies of the government? The India's ECB policy seeks to keep an annual cap or ceiling on access to ECB with prudent debt management. The policy also seeks to give greater priority for projects in the infrastructure and core projects that I've already mentioned, and the export sector also. Allowed companies are free to raise ECB from any internationally recognized source such as banks, export credit agencies, suppliers of equipment, foreign collaborator, foreign equity holders, international capital market, etc. Offers from the unrecognized sources will not be entertained. So that's it. Thank you very much for the discussion.